For Action News, I'm Mona Dolosky. A new study out of Denmark lends more support to the idea that the apparent rise in autism rates is unlikely to be real, and that the real reason for the increase is in how the disorder is tracked and diagnosed. Researchers looked at data from more than 660,000 children born in Denmark from 1980 through 1991. They determined that 60% of the increase in autism rates in the country could be attributed to the changes in the autism spectrum, the now broader list of symptoms, and how autism is defined. Those changes accounted for one-third of the increase in autism rates. ACTION's Director of Public Health, Ariel Sobranski, explains.
There was a study done in Denmark which found that the reason that autism diagnoses are increasing is twofold. One, it's because the definition of autism has expanded. So autism is now on a spectrum. So, you know, you could have very mild forms of autism spectrum disorder or typical autism that, you know, the way that we would have thought about autism years ago. So it's this whole spectrum, which means that it's going to encompass more people. The second reason for at least the population in Denmark is that they expanded the definition to include those cases that were diagnosed outside of healthcare facilities, so outpatients. And that also, you know, led to this hypothetical rise in the incidence of autism. We don't really know if that's the same reason that it seems to be on the rise in the United States, but obviously we're going to be seeing more cases than we were years ago. So that accounts for about 60% of this increase. There's another side, the 40% that we can't account for yet. There have been some theories that it has something to do with the age of parents. You know, now women are older, fathers are older when they're having their first child or, you know, consequent children. So that could possibly explain some of the rise as well, but we just really don't know.
To read more on this story and others, you can head to our website, action.org, and while you're there, don't forget to also sign up for your daily dose of news delivered straight to your inbox. For Action News, I'm Mona Dolosky.